Hello and welcome. My name is Partho Majumdar. So far, we have discussed what are regression models and we have got a fair idea regarding what is a regression model. Before we proceed to making regression models using Scikit-learn, let us discuss what are the different steps we need to take to create a regression model. You will notice that the steps are very similar for making any machine learning model. So let's discuss these steps. The first step in creating any model is to be able to define the problem. We need to be very clear about what is the problem we want to solve. Only then we can proceed to create an appropriate model for that. Once we have defined our problem, we need to set about gathering the data. Now, data gathering is not a very simple exercise. We need to be very clear where is the data going to be collected from, in what way the data will be collected so that we have a random sample, etc. Also, we need to be very clear what are the different parameters based on which data will be collected, and then we have to collate the whole data and then make it available for creating the model. Once we have gathered the data, we need to clean the data. Now, the data that we gather will always not be complete as we may expect. There will be a lot of missing information. There will be a lot of information that may be inappropriate, like we may find some data which has been typed wrongly and thus it is represented wrongly. So we need to clean the data. Now, after cleaning the data, we will find that we may have some data which is still missing and we may want to still retain it, and we may have to apply techniques like we may replace some missing data with some values, etc. So all these steps have to go into cleaning the data. Once we have the clean data available to us, we will have to pre-process the data. We have discussed a little bit about pre-processing in the previous videos, where we saw that we standardized or normalized the data because the ranges of values were too far apart from different variables. So these are all the steps which go into pre-processing the data. So once the pre-processed data is available, we can start making use of it for further action. Once we have the data ready for creating the model, we will have to create the training set and the test set. Now, this is a very important step, because we have to make critical decision regarding how much data we want to keep for training and how much data we want to keep for testing. Now, this decision is not very straightforward really. Supposing you have only 10,000 data points, then you may decide that 70% of the data will be kept for training and 30% of the data will be kept for testing. However, if you have 1 million data points, then keeping 30% or 20% data for testing may be too overwhelming. So we may want to keep just 1% data for testing, and the remaining data we may want to use it for training. So we have to create these two sets of training and test data at this stage. Once the training and test data is ready, we may also sometimes create a third set called the validation set. So once these are ready, we will proceed to make our models. Now we will create not one model, but we will create multiple models, because one model may not be sufficient to create a solution for our problem. So we will create multiple models, and for each model, we will proceed to tune the models. We will have to change multiple number of hyperparameters and see that the model is providing the best possible output. So we will do that possibly after the data gathering step. This is the step which takes the maximum amount of time. Once the models are ready, we will have to test the models. We will have to check how accurate the models are predicting for us. So we will have to do that. So for that, we may use the test data and check the models, or we may use the validation sets and check the models. Anyway, we will have to do a lot of testing to ensure that our models are going to behave properly and give the best possible results. Once we have tested the model, we should gather the statistics from the models based on the parameters what we would have defined. The parameters need to be appropriate for the problem that we are solving. Now, based on these parameters, we should make the selection of the best model which suits our requirement the best. Once we have selected the model for our use, we should start using the model for making predictions for the problem that we have got on hand. Now, if the models are good, it can save us a lot of time and it can save us a lot of money. So we need to go through this whole process very carefully and very diligently.